Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. Myself Chirag Godedra. I am assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering, Noble Group of Institutions. Today we will learn design of retaining wall. This topic is part of branch Civil Engineering subject DRCS, that is a design of reinforced concrete structures, which comes in seventh semester in degree engineering. So let's start the topic, the design of retaining wall. In our previous video, we have already discussed what is retaining wall, various applications of retaining wall, and which are the types of retaining wall. So now in this video, we will see the behavior of retaining wall under the loading and various forces which are acting on a retaining wall. So let us start with the behavior of a retaining wall, in which we will learn first the behavior of cantilever retaining wall. So now, as we can see in the figure, the first figure is the loads acting on a vertical wall, toe and his leg. So now this one is one cantilever retaining wall. This is stem, this is toe slab, and this is heel slab. So these are three loads, and this triangular load, that is because of the lateral load acting on the stem because of earth. Now this one, this is also the load because of weight of earth, but that is acting in gravity direction, and that is because of the weight of the earth retained on the hillside, and this load is on upward side, and this is because of cantilever action of toe slab. Now as we can see in the figure B, this is deflection profile. Now because of this lateral load due to this earth, this vertical stem tends to bend in this direction in outer side, and then this because of this weight of the earth, the hill slab tends to bend like this downward side, and because of cantilever action, this toe slab is tends to bend upward side. So as we can see in the figure, here the tension is on this side and here it is compression. Here this is tension on upper side, compression on lower side, and in toe slab there is a tension in downward side and compression on upward side. So now we all know that where we have to provide the reinforcement. We are providing the reinforcement where there is a tension. So here the tension is on the face towards the retained earth. So we have to provide the reinforcement here on this side. Now if we are talking about the heel slab, here the tension is on the upper surface. So we have to provide the reinforcement on upper side. And if we are talking about the toe slab, here the tension arises on the bottom side. So we have to provide main reinforcement on in bottom portions. So these are the behavior of a cantilever retaining wall, that is a figure for load. This is deflection profile and this is the reinforcement detail. So our next topic is behavior of a counterfort retaining wall. So in this figure there is one typical counterfort retaining wall, and to understand this concept of behavior of counterfort retaining wall, we have to take two section, that is section AA and section BB. So this one is vertical stem, right, and this is toe slab, this is heel slab, and these are the counterforts which are spaced at h by 3 distance between them. So now first one, section AA is taken on a vertical wall, that is on stem on this side, and section BB is taken on hillside slab, that is on the downward side. So as we can see in the figure B, that is for section AA on section on vertical wall, and figure C is for a section on hill slab, that is section BB. So let us now focus on section AA. Now, as we all know that here there is a retained earth mass, so that retained earth mass will act as a lateral earth pressure on vertical wall. So this vertical wall will be deflected like this, right? So this will be the deflected shape of a vertical wall because of lateral earth pressure. So here tension will be on this side and compression will be on this side, and here the tension will be on bottom and compression will be on top. Now we all know that we have to provide the reinforcement where when there is a tension. So we have to provide reinforcement here. I am talking about here. And when there are counter force, there is a tension on bottom side. So in this portion, we have to provide reinforcement towards the hill side, right? So these are the reinforcement details. Now, if we are talking about hillside slab, the section on the hillside slab, that is section BB. So here there is a retained earth mass. So that retained earth mass, the weight of, because of that weight of retained earth mass, this portion will be deflected like this. So tension will be on bottom side and compression will be on top side, and near the counter force, which acts as a support, the tension will be on top side and compression will be on bottom side. So now if we are talking about reinforcement details, so we have to provide reinforcement when there is a tension. So we have to provide reinforcement here for this portion. I am talking about this portion, and near the counter force that acts as a support, we have to provide reinforcement on the upper surface, right? So these are some reinforcement details for counter force retaining walls. And another concept is there will be cracks. So the figure D is showing the cracks in the interface of a counter force and vertical and hill slab. So this is vertical stem, this is a toe slab, and this is hill slab. This is vertical wall stem, this is counter force. So now we all know that counter force act as a tension member, right? So because of this tension member, there will be a separation of counter force with vertical force because of tension. This this is because of lateral earth pressure of backfill, and there will be also separation of counter force with hill slab, and this separation, this cracks is because of the weight of the earth mass of backfill. So these are some behavior of counter force retaining wall. Let us start with next topic, the forces acting on the retaining wall. So this is a figure of a retaining wall. In this figure, all the forces which acts on a typical retaining wall are mentioned. So the first force is lateral earth pressure. So this is the force which are applied by earth on the retaining wall. So there are here two types of earth pressure. First one is active earth pressure, another one is passive earth pressure. The difference between active and passive earth pressure are, the active earth pressure is the one which pushes the retaining wall away from the back hill, and passive earth pressures are the one which pushes the retaining wall towards the back fill. right? So these are two lateral earth pressure which acts on retaining wall. Another one is self weight of retaining wall, the self weight of stem and the self weight of heel and toe slab, W1 and W2. The third one is weight of soil above the base. So this here they are talking about this, the soil, the weight of this soil, that is W3, which acts in a gravity direction, and this self weight is also act in gravity direction. Fourth one is surcharge, that is the force due to loads on the earth surface. If there are some inclined surface of the soil, so it is taken as surcharge, so we have to take that load also in the account. Fifth one is a soil reaction below the base set. They are talking about this uplift pressure of soil because of this all this pressure. So here the maximum soil reaction will be on the toe side and minimum soil reaction will be on heel side. And last one is frictional force at the bottom of base slab. They are talking about here, and here the friction will be developed between this slab and the soil beneath the retaining wall. So here these are various forces acting on a retaining wall are clearly mentioned in this figure. So I hope you all understood this topic well. If you have any query or questions regarding this topic, you can write here in comment section below, or you can reach me at my mail address. Thank you. Have a nice day.